Because it was like mixed, I was like, well, like a green belt or something, going against black belt. And the guy popped my arm like a fucking cunt. You know what I mean? So, and then second time around, I fought this guy again. Got him in a rear naked choke. He had a cut on his lip. And I squeezed that hard, like blood was squirting out of his lip. Like, if I have that, you cunt. You know what I mean? Fuck off. So, yeah. I've competed with every belt.
Nice.
Yeah, I've always competed. I always say, you need to compete to get better. If you really want to get good at jiu-jitsu, you got to compete, mate. You got to test yourself in a stressful situation. Because I don't care what anyone says, it's stressful, right? You go on the mat, you don't know who you're fighting. You have to wait there sometimes for 8 hours before you fight. So it's a stressful situation. Yeah.
How do you go about like managing your emotions?
I just go lie down most of the time before I was coaching. I just chill in the corner somewhere and listen to music.
Just focus,
listen to music, just relax. Yeah, that's what I used to do. Just chill. Now obviously, most of the time now, if I compete, my guys are competing as well, so I'll be coaching and then competing, which is very tiring, both physically and mentally. So yeah, just chill, mate. I just walk around, talk to everyone. Especially the higher belt you get, the more people you know. So it's just like, hey, dude, how have you been? Yeah, good, man. And then, yeah. But the good thing is, like, higher grades, you'll be the last one, especially ultra heavy. So I've always fought ultra heavy. You're always the last ones to go, so that's how we get away with it.
Yeah.
So the guys with like white blue belts, they'll fight. I coach them. They're done then. And then usually my fight, I say like last year British Open, it was my fight was a half five or some shit. I've been there since 9 o'clock, coaching and doing other things. You know.
Okay.
Yeah. Mate, it's so annoying. Like. UK BJJ Underground is full of them. Stupid fucking questions. Like, oh, this is my first thing in jiu-jitsu, what should I do? I mean, just fucking walk up, mate. No one's gonna beat the shit out of you. They're all nice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Well, how do I get out of this? Figure it out, mate. 20 years ago, there's no internet. People just figured it out.
Yeah.
You know? Stop being a fucking pussy hole.
Yeah.
Like, if I go on UK BJJ Underground, mate, I just troll these guns, mate. They piss me off. Like, fucking stupid fucking question. Tell all your check, mate. Elbow him in the head. Punch him in the balls. You know what I mean? Fucking dumb ones. Sort it out. Yeah, of course you do, yeah. Just go. You wanna do it, just fucking go, mate. Just fucking try out. No, everyone's nice. No one's gonna beat you up. You know? It's just a gym, just people. let's go. Just rock up.
What would be, let's say you have you bumped into your wife or self.
Oh, yeah.
And is there going, oh, look, I want to train. I don't know if I should do it.
I tell them to train. Yeah, go train. Let's do it.
Yeah.
I've had a few friends like, I'm gonna wait till I'm fit to do jiu-jitsu. That's the thing that you get all the time. I need to be fit. No, you're gonna get fit doing jiu-jitsu. Just go.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? When I first started, I lost a lot of weight when I first started. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Yeah, I mean, just keep rocking up, man. Yeah, I mean, if you feel shit, go train. You know what I mean? Just keep rocking up, just keep doing it. And then for bigger guys, and even everyone, just like if you're a high grade, put yourself in bad situations. Don't be a cunt to smash everyone. You know what I mean? Put yourself in a deep choke so you can get out of it. Put yourself in a deep armbar so you can get out of it. That's only going to make you better. Because under that stress situation, it's safe, but it's still stressful. You need to get out. That's how you're going to get better. If you can do it, keep doing it in this safe situation, then it's going to be easier in the comp. You know? And yeah, discipline, and just keep walking up, mate. Just keep doing it. And roll a lot. Yeah, there's a lot of people like, oh, drilling and specific sparring. Yeah, it's all cool, but they're not really resisting. You know, you need to do it under pressure. You need to be able to perform that move under pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So if you and me are drilling, I'm not going to fucking squash it down, am I? You know what I mean? I'm not going to not stop you from doing the move. You're doing the move, I'm letting you do the move. You need to do that in sparring. Have like 10 rounds, 10 5-minute rounds, mate, do that. It's going to get you better. I know people are like, oh, no, it's not. But it is, though. It really is, because you say muscle memory. Yeah, it's muscle memory at weak. weak muscle memory. It's like, oh, it's doing this really slow, moving this really slow. Do it in full contact, do it then. Then you get a spot on them. Or full contact, you know. And I was always interested in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, because I was always looking on YouTube. It's like, oh, this is cool, you know, like the Gracie challenges, and like, this is fucking cool, this. So it's a bit of research, and I found Gracie Bar, Leeds. And then I said, fuck it, I'm gonna go. I went down on a Friday, and this was an open mat. It wasn't a lesson. It was just Pete Hall, James Orr, Plasniak. I think David was there as well. And I just got beat up for like an hour. And it was the best thing ever. From that moment up, I knew it was like, yeah, this is for me. Yeah, there's no kids. I mean, kids are cool, right? But you know, if you want to do something, you want just adults there. You know, you can swear to each other, do whatever. And it was just amazing. You know, just getting beat up by these big guys. Even smaller guys were beating me up. I'm like, what the fuck is this shit? I thought it was strong. And these guys are just beating me, you know what I mean? So that's how I got into it. And I got the bug from then, mate. You know what I mean? I mean, about 6 months in, at my first comp at White Belt, Nottingham Open, got gold in that. At like, no points scored against me on that one. Second comp, Empire. Well, it wasn't Empire then, it was Grapple Nation then. Again, I won that. So I got the bug straight away, mate. Yeah, it was amazing.
Tell me about, what was your preparation?
For comps?
Yeah.
Mate, I was like, I came from a striking background, so I was like, well, I'm not going to get knocked out, so what have I got to fear? I'm just super chilled, you know what I mean? Because I can, I don't know how many matches I've had, but I've had quite a few matches, you know what I mean? Probably in the 50s, you know, of taekwondo and karate as well. So I wasn't too bothered, you know, especially a white belt. So see how it goes. Yeah. I think I've beat my first guy 9-0, second two guys, I submitted them. So yeah, and they got gold. I was like, yeah, this is for me, this is soundness. This is my kind of thing, you know, strangling people. You know what I mean? So yeah, it's good. Yeah.
Well,
it was pretty easy. Like I said, the karate was Wataru based, so we did have a little bit of Newaza in there. Albeit like very shit. Because you used to have like national, like local comps, like, between the karate clubs. And we used to do a bit of ground fighting, so they make you start back to back. Hands out, legs out, and then they start with a spin round. And you couldn't come up on, you could come up onto one knee and that's it, but you couldn't stand up.
Okay.
Yeah. So I had a bit of experience of competing in grappling. Yeah, I mean, there's been a few starting off a jiu-jitsu journey, like, so as a white belt. And I know I'm big, but like rolling with purple brown belts and then submitting them, and then they're not being happy about it. you know, it's like it's all ego in it. You know, they say, oh, there's no ego in jiu-jitsu, mate. There's massive egos in jiu-jitsu. Are you serious? It's mental. You know. So yeah, I can submit to them and pop in some guy's arm, which he popped himself and blamed me for it. You know, yeah. Or like, oh, you're slamming me. Like, I just picked you up, mate, from Turtle and turned you over. That's it, I didn't slam you. I didn't pick you up and actually slammed you. You know? Oh yeah, definitely. Like, especially for competing, it's like, what have I got to worry about? Because you know, I'm giving like brown belts, like good brown belts, a hard time. Just fine white belts, don't give a shit. Just get into it and do it. You know, that's what I thought. And I'm not going to get knocked out, so that's fine.
It's a big element, though, isn't it? You can train in this sport, like, just absolutely 100%. And there's very low risk
of actual injury, yeah. When you trust each other, yeah, definitely, yeah. Yeah. Not many. Yeah, of course it is, yeah. Like, you need to take care of each other, right? I'm not going to break your leg, then you can't train. You know, we make each other better. No, that's why I said, like, I've been thinking about this as a whole, like it's a West Yorkshire thing. We should all get together in this train and make it get better as a whole rather than just individual teams.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because that's what they do down south. You know what I mean? So.
Someone said this to me once, and it was when we started our own gym in Thailand. And there was another gym out there. And we were like, oh, what about this gym? Are they going to be, you know, upset about it? And the guy said to me, don't look at it as like you versus them.
No.
Look at it about like raising the level.
Exactly. Yeah, that's what you want to do.
Yeah,
it's not, it shouldn't be like, oh, fucking scramble or whatever, or fucking crazy bar. Fuck it, you know, the more the merrier. It's only going to get better. The more minds thinking about different things, it's just going to elevate the game, isn't it, you know?
Exactly, yeah. So what do you think, like, on the jiu-jitsu politics?
It's made it everywhere, aren't they? It's not just jiu-jitsu politics, it's everywhere. Karate politics, taekwondo politics, sure, wrestling politics. It's just people, isn't it? People being people with their egos, you know, that's what that is. You can never get rid of it, no matter what you do. Even if you do yoga, there'll still be politics in that, right? So, you know, it's mental.
So what's your solution to it?
You know, just be chill, man, you know. Fuck your ego. Don't give a shit. Just fucking chill and be nice.